greetings. Allah is incomparable, or is He? Comparison occurs when you evaluate two or more things. Two things may be equal, and the definition of equal depends on the things being considered. But do you know the biggest indicator that you are making a comparison? You use a comparison word. The three most common and most general comparison words are good, better, best. On the scale of comparison, good means that the thing or its attribute is positive and desirable. Good is a general comparison, not against any other specific instance of competitors. Better is a comparison between two members of the group. In a category or attribute where a value may be objectively determined, better is the way to describe the individual with a superior value as judged according to the attribute being compared. Better requires comparison with at least one other competitor. Best is the ultimate positive comparison. It means that the one ascribed best is superior to every other competitor. Best is a comparison against all other competitors. Someone or something cannot be called the best unless they have been compared to every other competitor. But remember, Allah is incomparable. Allah is not comparable. Surah 354. Allah is the best of the planners, or best of the schemers. Remember, to be declared best, Allah must have been compared to every other planner. Surah 3:150. Allah is the best of helpers. Surah 3:173. Allah is the best disposer of affairs. Remember, this is Allah the incomparable the Quran is comparing all to. Surah 5:114. Allah is the best of sustainers. Doesn't Allah have to compete in the Sustainers World Cup to win this title? Surah 6:57 and 7:87. Allah is the best of judges. Perhaps He is better than Judge Judy, but she has a TV show. Surah 7:155. Allah is the best of those who forgive. You know, Allah will have to go away to surpass Jesus' forgiving while hanging on the cross. Maybe that's why Allah denies the whole event ever took place. Surah 8:30. Allah is the best of planners. Comparing the incomparable Allah to all the planners. Surah 10:109 and 12:80. Allah is the best of judges. Allah's really working to get His own show. Surah 21:89. Allah is the best of inheritors. You know, it's not like winning the lotto multiple times. You keep inheriting from dead relatives, and the police are gonna start asking questions. Surah 22:58. Allah is the best of those who make provision. I think an average Boy Scout will surpass Allah in being prepared. And there are so many to compare against the uncomparable Allah. Surah 23:14. Allah is the best of creators. I suppose if there is only one creator, Allah is also the worst of creators. That is, if you want to be logically thorough and complete in your comparison of the Allah who cannot be compared. Maybe it's only me, but for Allah being uncomparable, the Quran sure makes a right good effort at comparing Him to many things. Surah 23:29. Allah is the best of those who bring to land. I think that means Allah is the best navigator or sailor, but I'd be more impressed if Allah could outdrink every sailor in the sea. Surah 23:72. Allah is the best of those who give sustenance. That pretty much compares Allah to every breastfeeding woman on the planet. The Quran comparing Allah to women with breasts. Surah 23:109 and Surah 23:118. Allah is the best of those who show mercy. Well, now we know the voting is rigged. Mother Teresa won this one going away. Surah 34:39 and 62:11. Allah is the best of providers. Seems we've seen this claim of providing before. I think Muhammad simply ran out of ideas for categories for Allah to be compared in. I didn't even start the other comparison words. Most. Allah is the most beneficent. Allah is the most merciful. I've said it before, but it merits repeating. Muhammad's man-made Allah is nothing more than a man-imagined Superman. Even the Islamic death chant, Allahu Akbar, meaning Allah is greater, is nothing more than a desperate comparison against the God of the Christians and Jews. So Muslims, I have some questions for you. If your Allah is incomparable, why does your Quran make so many comparisons against him? You see, it is your religion, Islam, that tries to make this an important aspect of your claim to legitimacy. But I find the desperate need for Muhammad's Allah to be compared to be proof that this Allah is not a real deity at all. If you are a Muslim, ask yourself why Allah needed to compare himself so much and so often. If the Allah of Islam was actually God, his greatness would speak for itself. And yet, not so strangely, Allah felt over and over the need to claim superlative status. But that is why I call this reason number 12 to reject Islam and the Allah of Islam. Allah is so insecure, he must compare himself to all these things, to all these men. Think about it. Remember, this is Allah having to compare himself, comparing himself to men. And that is why I reject the insecure Allah of Islam. And this is reason number 12. If you can imagine any reasons Allah has to compare himself to men, please let me know. I'm sure your excuse will be entertaining and illogical. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.